It is currently 9:44, so this is gonna be a quick video. Don't ask me why I decided to make this video right now, but we're gonna do it. So anyways, welcome back to my channel. For those who don't know me, my name is Jaleesa, and in this video I'm gonna be telling you guys a little bit about my smiley. For those who don't know, it is that little piece of meat that's connected to your top lip and your gums. So like I did for my tongue piercing video, I'm gonna show you guys the clip of me getting it done, and then I'm gonna come back and I'm gonna talk about it. So see you guys just now.
Deep breath. All right, hold your lip for me. You can let go. All right, now hold again. Hold a little bit higher. Perfect. Sit up for me.
So, excuse me. I don't know where to start. Smiley piercing was probably one of my easiest piercings ever. Like the healing process, me getting it done, everything was like perfect. I did write down some stuff in my notes so I can talk to you guys about. Things you should know before getting a smiley is, if your lips are extremely big like mine's, you should get a longer earring. I know it's not an earring. I say earring a lot, so you guys are gonna hear me say that. You should get a longer earring so that you can see it, because when I smile you can't see it. If you have a bigger lip, you should get a longer ring for it to show. For my healing process with my smiley, my healing process honestly was not bad, and the reason that it was not bad is because, once again, I have bigger lips, so it really wasn't getting in the way of anything. So when I ate and everything, so I didn't start off with this. I didn't get pierced with this one here. I got pierced with this one right here. I don't know if you guys can see it. I guess you would call that one the horseshoe. Imagine this one in my mouth, like how small that looks. So it was like really out of the way. With me eating and chewing gum and everything, like everything was good, like it stayed out the way. So I would recommend for people, when you're first getting started, I would get a smaller ring so that the healing process would be easy, and you know, as you heal and it doesn't hurt anymore, get something bigger so that when you smile you can see it. The only time that it did hurt was when I rubbed my face. Like I would forget and I would do something like that. Or if I was sick during the time I got it done. So when I would blow my nose, so imagine you and you blow your nose and everything and you're wiping, it was hurting. It was hurting really bad. So that, and then also when I smiled or I laughed too hard, it would bring up my top lip with it and it would hurt. Those are the only times where it affected me. Other than that, I was good. But things you should know when getting it. Well, I only have one thing to tell you about it. I met this guy in one of the piercing shops I went to. And he had the smiley previously. And he was telling me about how it's not good and this and that. Because the jewelry, it rests on that. He had the captive bead ring, I want to say. I'm going to change my earring out tonight. So I'll show you guys that. But he had the captive bead ring. For those who don't know what that is, hold on. I should have took this out beforehand, but I didn't. So tonight, I'm going to switch it out to this right here. Hope you guys can see it. I have to clean it, and then I'm gonna switch it to that. So anyways, he had the captive bead ring, which is this, and I guess with the ball resting in place, you know, just sitting there all day every day, it turned in between here black, like it was black. So I guess that's one thing you should know. I don't know if maybe if you should probably switch them out or whatever the case is. And some people, you know, that don't really have a larger lip like me, it hangs down on their teeth and it hits. And I also heard that that is not good too. I mean, a lot of stuff that we do, it isn't good for us, but we still do it. So anyways, yeah, that's two things that I learned that, you know, they're not good. So that's, you know, two things to keep in mind if you guys are thinking about getting the piercing. Other than that, I really don't have much to say about this. This was like one of my easiest piercings ever. The healing process was amazing. It really didn't hurt that bad when she did it. And yeah, that's all I have to say. I'm gonna go change it out and I'll be right back to show you guys. So I've been gone for like an hour. Not really, but it feels like it. I was trying to get my new ring in and having some difficulties and I'm getting frustrated. So yeah, this is what it looks like. It's supposed to be the captive bead ring. It's the stupidest thing ever. Like, it literally, like, it's not even like you have to screw it in or anything. It's like two indents in the ball that you just have to place in there. Anyways, I'm gonna have to go to my piercer and I'm gonna have to make her do it because I'm getting angry. So I'm just showing you guys what this one looks like. It's supposed to have a little bead in the middle. It looks like it's long enough now, so you'll finally see it when I smile. So yeah, I'm just gonna go to my piercer so she can put it in for me tomorrow. But in the meantime, I'm gonna switch back to the one that I started out with when I first started doing this video. I hope I helped you guys with anything. If you guys have any questions, leave it in the comment section below. If you guys want to see anything else, just let me know. Thank you for subscribing and supporting and all that good stuff that I see in each video. I'm about to take my black A to bed. I got my little, got my thing ready and everything. So I'll see you guys soon. Thank you.